Hello, fans. Welcome to this presentation of the NBA Sunday Night Action right here on 2K Sports. This is Kevin Harlan along with Steve Kerr and Clark Kellogg. We'll hear from Dwayne. They get a hand on it. Beasley dishes to Bledsoe. And Bass kicks to Bledsoe. And there's the feed to Fry. Passes it to Bass. Beasley outside. The three-pointer no good. The Thunder leading by 13. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
I was able to talk with Jeff Hornacek for a moment. He told me one of the more troubling tasks his team must do is to figure out how to slow down Russell Westbrook. He said that between his explosiveness and ability to change direction, they'll have to have all five guys keeping an eye on Westbrook whenever he's on the perimeter.
Thanks, Doris. And Phoenix making a change here. Here's Fisher. He's guarded by Bass. Here's Cephalosha. Drops in the tray. And the Thunder lead by 14. Phoenix has gone 1-5 from downtown in the first quarter. Points out there have been hard to come by. Bass passes to Beasley. Butler, covered by Cephalosha, bounces high off the rim and drops. Butler's got five. Now here is Cephalosha. Pass to Fisher. He kicks it to Ibaka. And Michael Beasley picks up the foul. That's his first foul.
Yeah, close, but I didn't think he got on balance quickly enough.
And it's hard to draw charges as quick as players are at this level. That's not an easy bit of work there.
Ibaka goes in. Working on Beasley. Down to five on the shot clock. Shot's good by Ibaka.
Wow, just a tremendous first quarter shooting the basketball for them, guys.
Yeah, when they put it up, it's gone in.
And Bass kicks to Green. He feeds it to Bass. Beasley sets a screen for Bass. Bass gets the screen from Beasley. Can't get it to go. Great D that time from Collison.
In terms of rebounding, it's been a sensational opening quarter.
I like sensational. That's a good word for it.
Again, Oklahoma City.
They're really struggling defensively, giving up too many easy buckets.
And they've been on fire offensively as a result, Clark.
Dishes it to Green. And stolen by Cephalosha. And boy, that looked like goaltending. Yes, it is. And so they will award the basket there.
He didn't get to that one quite in time, Kevin. Those can be tough to gauge sometimes.
So for the Suns, Gortat has come in for Channing Frye. And Markieff Morris subbed in for Michael Beasley. And Bass kicks to Gortat. A beautiful reverse layup.
Looked like he may have been showboating a little bit at the end of that one.
The Thunder leading by 16. Cephalosha dishes to Fisher. It's stolen by Bass. And now it's Brown.
Oh, man, that was unreal.
Mark it up. Even when they're down, he's still looking to do the spectacular. And he pulled it off.
Well, maybe, yeah, maybe this is the best time to do it.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, now's when they need a little spark anyway.
Now here is Cephalosha. 5 points in the game. Got a piece of it. Bass pass.
Oh! Are you kidding me?
That was a power punch right there.
Oh, great. The Rim Rattler.
Just a remarkable jam. These fans' jaws are on the ground right now.
Yeah, that is showtime stuff right there. Major highlight reel material.
Perkins. The finger roll finish at the bucket. Perkins got his first basket of the night.
Their offense has really come together immediately, threatening to run away with this game.
It's hard to imagine they'll be able to stay as hot as they've been so far, but if they can, watch out.
Brown. Good.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
I just love the mentality they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing anything. They're moving it side to side and working to get a good shot.
Nambas kicks to Brown. The shot is off. Great tee that time from Zapolosha. Pass to Fisher. Takes it from 10. Zapolosha. He dishes it to Fisher. And a double-digit lead on the scoreboard as we end the... And welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. More action in store as the players get ready to go, having a nice break to get hydrated with Gatorade. And Steve and Clark and I are refreshed and ready to go here as well. And let's get your take, guys, on the scoring breakdown for the Thunder.
Well, they've definitely had the hot hand from the three-point line so far. Always nice to start out like that.
They've established their presence in the paint tonight. Also, a lot of their scoring to this point coming from down low.
Backcourt tandem, Westbrook and Jeremy Lamb. Ian Gomes is out there with Durant, and it's Perkins, and at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group for Oklahoma City getting going here in the second.
You know, there was a time when the Suns were an up-and-down team. They'd push the tempo and do everything they could to get layups and shoot the three. Those days are history now. They're just not a very good shooting team from outside anymore.
Two open that time, made it look too easy. Lamb's got the second quarter going with the first basket of the period for the Thunder. And Bass kicks to Brown. Pass. Shot clock at 6. Back to Brown. And they wasted no time getting those 3 points back. Brown's got 10 points. Well, Clark, you said the Suns didn't shoot the ball well from distance. They would end up 28th in the NBA when it came to the deep ball.
Wow, look at that athletic play. Incredible.
Wow.
You know, sort of surprising he goes for a slam that difficult. While they're trailing?
Yeah, but still, you know what? A magnificent move to the rim.
Agreed. Guys, look, I don't know what the score is. That's the play we're all going to remember from this game.
And Gomes kicks to Westbrook. Lamb. No good with the triple.
You know, one thing with Scott Brooks, guys, he's very consistent with his message. You listen in on those timeouts. It's all about getting stops. Defense, 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 and letting their offense come from that.
All alone. And that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got 3 assists now in this one.
And now a look at Russell Westbrook, some stats on him. Great year for him last year. He was 6th in scoring, 7th in assists, and a guy with a real nose for the ball. Aggressive defender, put him in the top 10 in steals last season.
And you know, Steve, going back to his scoring average for a second, I mean, you can see what a go-to guy he was for them all season long. They really counted on him to carry the load. Textbook example there of how to use defense to create offense.
Yeah, beautiful transition play after the steal all the way to the basket.
Wasted no time going from defense to offense.
And it feels like they're starting to pick up the intensity as the game itself starts to get a little more tight and close.
Nick Collison's checked in for Oklahoma City. Ibaka comes in for Kevin Durant. And Clark, you mentioned Brooks' single-mindedness. He stayed pretty constant with his rotations, too.
And there's no doubt players appreciate knowing their role, but, you know, a lot of critics have been surprised at how Brooks has stuck to his lineups. Some lineups that didn't seem to be all that effective. You know, his usual starting lineup with Cephalosha and Perkins on the floor hasn't been their best in terms of plus-minus, but Brooks, very loyal to his starting group.
Fades away. Misses off the left iron.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
Well, in terms of his value to the team, you have to factor in his sheer competitiveness, the way he just competes every possession like the game depends on.
And that's contagious, Steve. And I know his teammates love playing with him because of that competitive spirit. You know, free throw shooting is always critical in terms of outcomes of games. And the Thunder last year often had an advantage at the line. Not only did they get there at a high rate, they made their free throws at a high rate as well.
The Thunder leading by 16. Kicks to Ibaka. No good. Great D that time from Bass.
Not too much congestion in the lane. I think he could have gotten a better shot that time, no question.
Puts the lead pass in front of him. And he'll shoot free throws here. Clearly fouled on that shot that time, the whistleblower. Best shooting team at the free throw line last season by a good margin. Clark, you're right, the Thunder shot 83% as a team. Very nice percentage for any player, much less an entire team, Steve, and actually the third best for a team in league history.
And as we talked about earlier, Kevin, it wasn't just the makes, it was the attempts. I mean, this is a club that can slash and attack the basket. They finished second in the NBA in free throw attempts. So what a combination to be able to get to the rim, get to the free throw line, and then convert.
Green dishes the pass. Good ball movement here by the Suns. And that one is good by Beasley.
You know, the teardrop sometimes is one of those, oh no, oh no, oh yeah, shots.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to Doris Burke for an update. Hi, Doris.
Well, guys, Thunder in the last outing against the Jazz put together a nice one. He dropped 14 points, and in addition to his scoring, he also came away with a season high for rebounds. Overall, just an incredible bonus for his team as he made a big impact coming off the bench.
All right, Doris, well, guys, coming off a performance like that has got to have him supremely confident right now.
Well, that never seems to be a problem for him, but you're right, Kevin. He has to be feeling at the top of his game right now.
Well, when you play well, it feeds confidence, and when you've prepared to play well and it works out that way, it does add another level of confidence to your next game.
And Green gets it to go.
They are absolutely stroking it from outside. I mean, textbook perfect. Good balance, nice high release, splash. After taking a year to play elsewhere, it seems Gerald Green finally found his role on an NBA team in the 2011-12 season, but he just couldn't find the traction expected with the Indiana Pacers last year.
The Thunder leading by seven. Sevalosia with it. Now Green defending. Sevalosia passes to Westbrook. It's stolen by Bass. Green kicks to Bass. Flushes it down to finish the break.
And the defense paying instant dividends. Fast break basket.
Yeah, that transition was immediate. Didn't waste a second getting out on the break.
And for Gerald Green, a three-year...
Oh, what a throwdown there.
Man, he got fancy with that one, didn't he?
Yeah, maybe trying to give them the...
And now, brought to you by Sprint.
Welcome to 2K Sports,
the Sprint Halftime Report, presented by Sprint.
And Fisher kicks to Westbrook. He passes to Durant. Shoots from the baseline. Gets the bucket. Durant's got 24 points.
He's been one of their more reliable options today, guys. I mean, his shooting has led them to this lead.
And Phoenix looking who they've got on the floor. Bass, he's in at the point. Channing Frye out there with Caron Butler. Then there's Dragic, and it's Green in at the three, the small forward. Bass can't get it to go.
They're really getting the work done inside with their rebound.
Yeah, not giving up too many second chance opportunities, which is always important, and it's been one of the reasons they have the lead right now. And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
Now the pass to Dragic. Feeds to Bass. There's the dish to Green. Passes to Bass. Six to shoot. Back to Green. Let's the three fly. And the Suns miss again. Oklahoma City comes into this one after the win against the Minnesota Timberwolves.
And they did just what you have to do as a road team, guys. They never allowed any momentum to build up against them. Seemed like every time they took a punch, they had a counter.
You'll like this, Steve. Reverse spurtability, we call that. If they had any defensive lapses, they immediately made up for it with some instant offense.
The feed to Westbrook. And that comes off the assist by Derek Fisher. Fisher's got three assists tonight.
Beautiful finger roll to cap the head drive off. He knows how to finish with some flair and flavor, guys.
They set the screen. Dragic kicks the butt. And he gets the friendly spin, and that one drops. Butler's got 9. The Thunder leading by 12. Collison with a screen for Westbrook. Pass to Roberson. 6 on the shot clock. He kicks to Durant. A fader. Again, Oklahoma City.
Offensively, he can be the engine that drives them at any given time.
Here's Bass. And that one comes up a bit short.
You got to give them a lot of credit for the job they've done on the backboard.
Well, they've done a lot of things right, but I agree with you, Parker. Their rebounding is right there at the top of the list.
Good. And it's now a at the 4 with Perkins at the pivot. Russell Westbrook out there with Reggie Jackson. And it's Durant in at the 3-7. That's the lineup out there for the Thunder.
He's really slowed down a bit here in the second half. He hasn't converted a 3 yet after the tremendous first half he had.
Here's Butler. And he sinks that one in the back of the rim on the way in.
You don't see the wide open fadeaway shot too often.
Out of bounds, Phoenix will take possession. Here's what Phoenix has lined up on their schedule. Looking ahead to their next game, playing at New Orleans, they'll match up against the Pelicans. That matchup falls in the middle game of this 3-game trip. Thabo Sefolosha has checked in for Oklahoma City. Now, here's Bass. He's covered by Westbrook. Bass gets the screen for Morris. Here's Brown. Good on the shot, and that shaves the lead to single digits. Brown's got 20 points.
Very effective screen to set up the jumper. That was the key to that play.
Sefolosha dishes to Westbrook. Ibaka with a screen on Brown. Westbrook with it. Picked up by Brown. Here's Durant. Phoenix grabs the miss. Bass has got 3 rebounds now in this one. This game coming after a loss against the Jazz.
Their defense got absolutely destroyed in that game as they weren't closing out on the perimeter shooters. They were allowing people to get into the paint and score from point-blank range. Just an overall abysmal effort.
Yeah, something was missing, no doubt about that. They let an opponent shoot a really high percentage, and that's got to be a concern going forward.
Westbrook kicks to Sefolosha, and that comes off the assist by Russell Westbrook. Westbrook's got his 7th assist in the game. Here's Bass. It's rebounded by Durant. Durant's got his 6th rebound on the night.
They've been the glass eaters today, guys. A ton of effort out of them down low.
Well, they've needed every one of those rebounds. I think that's what's put them in front here.
And the lead just grows on that ridiculous offensive sequence.
You know, Clark, that dunk alone would have been spectacular. Never mind it coming at the end of an alley-oop.
Yeah, that just added more to it.
Yeah, what a beautiful connection on that play.
Kept alive. Here's Gortat. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him 2 chances at the free throw line here.
And the defense looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Yeah, I like that. A foul to save the layup. Make him earn it at the line.
And he ends up missing both free throws.
You know, so much has been said about the Oklahoma City home court advantage, and for good reason. I mean, you can feel it and hear it. I'm like a college atmosphere.
That's a good point. Durant, that's good.
The easiest way to do it sometimes is with the bounce pass.
Butler, defended by Durant. Bass passes to Butler. Backs down, and Bass kicks to Morris. Now Bass, just 5 on the clock. Phoenix needs to get off a shot. Here's Butler, and misses it off the right side of the rim. Clark, back to what you said. Not only can you hear it when they are here, you can literally feel it. The rumbling, Steve, when you first come out of the tunnel is amazing.
Well, the Thunder have a fantastic team, Kevin. And, you know, they've been good the last few years, but you don't go 34-7 at home like they did last season without a significant advantage coming from the crowd. And I think that's been the case here. The crowd is loud and active and fired up every single night.
And now Doris Burke has an update from the sidelines.
Yes, Kevin, during that last break, I heard Jeff Hornacek as he addressed his team. He was not happy with their play to this point, telling them we're getting out hustled, plain and simple. There's still time, but we've got to dial up our effort. Kevin, we'll see if they have enough to get it done.
Thank you, Doris. Now a timeout called by Oklahoma City.
Well, you know, the Suns dropped from being a team that could fight for a playoff spot to the cellar of the West last season, and much of that you could attribute to how much they struggled on the road.
Butler with the steal. Pass with it. Westbrook picks him up. And here's Brown outside. No good. And Oklahoma City will go with it the other way. At one point, they led by 16. Well, the Suns did have a lot of trouble on the road, as you were saying, Clark. Only managed to win 8 games as the visiting team, Steve, the entire season. That's not good.
Well, 8 wins is unacceptable. I mean, it actually tied the Suns with the Kings for the fewest road wins in the entire conference. So, look, this is a young team. They have a lot of learning to do. They've got to add talent. I think the rebuilding project has started, and they're going to get better, but it's still going to take some time.
The Thunder leading by 10.
Come on, baby, let's get one more.
He logs up the alley-oop pass, and Ibaka shuts it in.
A little bit of a magic act here, pulling off the Houdini to make that catch and slam.
Stupendous, stupendous alley-oop.
Ooh, this crowd just stunned at the sight of that one.
He feeds it to Morris. Brown outside. Butler dishes to Bass. And it's blocked by Cephalosha.
Boy, they've really won the battle of the boards in this one, Kevin.
Durant kicks to Cephalosha. From past the arc. Here's Perkins. And he dunks it down. Breaking down some numbers here. The hustle stats for Oklahoma City.
Their defense has been outstanding, Kevin. Closing out on shots, blocking a lot of them as well.
Another part of their game that's made a difference tonight is all the second chance points they've been able to get.
Bass passes to Brown. A strong finish under heavy pressure all over. Brown's got 27.
Man, he has been their unquestioned leader offensively this quarter.
Dishes it to Westbrook. .114 left in the fourth quarter. Bass with it. Guarded now by Durant. Gortat with the screen for Bass. Pass to Butler. He dishes it to Bass. And with that one, the lead is trimmed to single digits. That gives him a double-double in this one. 10 points and 11 assists. Cephalosha dishes to Westbrook. It's stolen by Bass. He hits Brown with the drive. Bass with it. Now guarded by Cephalosha. And Bass kicks to Brown. Another one falls for Phoenix. Now here is Cephalosha. There's 31 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. It's Westbrook with the drive and finished off by Perkins. Great game for him. Double-double now. 11 points and 13 rebounds.
Time to turn out the lights on this game.
I think they deserve a ton of credit for the way they played here today. Truly a professional display.
Brown the pass to Morris. Off target with his three. And here is Durant. Outside Westbrook. So it's Oklahoma City picking up the win. Both teams played well, but these guys had the edge.
Yeah, I think so. They were just steak knife sharp. Very on top of their game here.
Well said. And that'll wrap it up.
Tonight, for the first time, you cracked double digits in assists. Did you see this coming before the game, or did it end up being a bit of a surprise?
Of course I saw it coming. A player like me isn't going to be getting that many assists without intending to. Normally, I'm going to shoot the ball every chance I get, but tonight, I felt like doing things a little differently. And here I am cracking double digits. I told you guys I could do it. Should have listened to me before. Might have saved you some of the surprise.